This is FFA Poultry Judging, Class 1, Meat Type Birds for Breeder Selection, the Cull-Keep class. First, students should review the FFA manual to become familiar with the chicken anatomy so that they will be familiar with the parts of the chicken that must be examined. This includes the comb, beak, wattles, breast, keel bone, hock, shanks, toes, abdomen, vent, tail, and wing feathers. Other parts of the chicken's anatomy that are important when determining coloration would be the vent, the eye ring, the earlobe, the beak, the bottom of the feet, the entire shank, and the hock and tops of toes. This poultry judging class will consist of 8 young broiler breeder chickens in individual cages. The objective in this class is to select 4 of the birds to use as breeders. A set of oral reasons may be required for this class, and students will be informed on the day of the competition which classes will be used for oral reasons. The birds will be of the same age and strain, raised together under the same environmental conditions. Now, you may handle each broiler breeder, but only with the bird inside the cage. When evaluating a bird, it is advised to raise the bird from the cage floor to a standing position. Have the bird take a few steps to properly evaluate leg, feet, and toes. Broiler breeder selection will be based on criteria that include deformities, body conformation, and breast meat quantity. Students should look for deformities such as green shanks, severely crooked toe or toes, one or more solid black feathers, permanent absence of mane tail feathers, wry or crooked neck, leg and foot abnormalities that affect the bird's ability to walk, crossed beak, blind in one or both eyes, severely crooked back, or severely crooked keel. Deformities in broiler breeder selection are defined as serious body defects that the bird could transmit to its offspring and or that reduce the bird's value as a breeder. Any bird having one or more of these deformities is an automatic cull. Looking closely, this bird has a severely crooked toe and would be culled. This bird would be culled because it has a crooked leg. After removing automatic culls from the list of possible breeders, examine the remainder by using body conformation and breast meat quality. Let's look at selecting a bird based on its body conformation. Body conformation of a broiler breeder refers to the bird's structure. Evaluating a broiler breeder's body conformation requires measuring the width across the shoulders, the length of the back, the depth of the body, the length of the keel, the spring of the ribs, and the width across the hips. Measurements can be estimated by touching the birds with the hands. Body length should be proportionally larger than the body width. The width across shoulders should be 75% of the length of the back. The depth of body, which would be measured from the backbone to the keel bone, should be equal to or exceed the width across shoulders at both the front and rear of the keel bone. This will make the keel parallel to the back. The length of the keel should be equal to or greater than the width across the shoulders. The spring of the ribs should equal the width across the shoulders. The width across the hips should exceed the width across the shoulders. Now we will look at examining a bird for breast meat quantity. Breast meat quantity is closely related to body conformation, and the breast meat quantity on a broiler breeder refers to the amount of muscling in the breast area. Similar to body conformation, breast meat quantity can be objectively measured. To evaluate a broiler breeder's breast meat quantity, you would measure the length of muscling, the depth of muscling, the width of muscling, and the carry of muscling. Measurements can be estimated by handling the birds. The length of muscling is determined by the length of the keel. The length of muscling should extend the full distance along the keel bone and be approximately 1.5 times greater than the width of muscling. A short breast is indicated when the length of the muscling is almost equal to the width of the muscling. A long breast is indicated when the length of the muscling is almost 1.5 times greater than the width of the muscling across the breast. The depth of muscling is determined by the depth of the body. The depth of muscling should be equal to or greater than the width of muscling. The keel bone should also run parallel to the backbone. Width of muscling and carry of muscling are related. The width of muscling is determined by the width of breast between the points of wing attachment. The carry of muscling is determined by how well the breast meat width carries from the front to the rear. Narrow breast indicates poor width of muscling. The muscling is rounded and the width does not carry from the front to the rear of the bird. This is referred to as a tapered breast. A wide breast indicates good width of muscling. The muscling is flattened and the width carries well from the front to the rear end of the bird. The breast muscling should be wide and flat in front, and this width and flatness should carry to the rear of the breast. The muscling should not come to a sharp point at the rear of the keel, but should form a blunt end. Finally, the best four birds with regard to body conformation and breast meat quantity should be selected for keeping.